Hey guys, welcome back to new video. In this video, we're going to design a very simple pedometer app. In this application, we will learn how to manage sensors, how we can access sensor, what is sensor manager, and how we can access a particular specific sensor for our use case. So let's get started without wasting any time and create this beautiful, very simple application, pedometer. In order to access sensors, first we have to use sensor manager. Sensor manager is actually used to manage our sensors. Just like we are having notification manager to manage our notifications, we are having alarm manager to manage our alarm. Similarly, here we are having sensor manager, which actually used to manage our sensors. So first, let's create that sensor manager, private wall, and I'm going to call this sensor manager, and type would be sensor manager, and I'm going to use your lazy block. In this, I'm going to take my system service. With the help of context.sensor service, I'm going to receive my sensor service. Now I'm going to type this thing into sensor manager. Next, I'm going to create my sensor that we will use to detect the step counter. So again, sensor type is sensor. Initialize this thing with the null. Now it's time to initialize my sensor. So go in your on create, use sensor, and initialize this thing with the help of sensor manager dot get default sensor. In this, you have to mention the type of your sensor that you want. So for that, use sensor dot. We are having a lot of sensor: type step detector, type step counter, type wall, type light, type gravity, accelerometer. But for me, I'm gonna use here step detector because I want to detect the steps. Okay, so I have to change this thing from wall to wire because I want to reinitialize this thing during my program execution. So we are done with our sensor initialization. Now it's time to register this sensor with the help of our sensor manager. So for that, use your sensor manager dot register listener. In this, we are having sensor event listener. So sensor event listener is an interface, and this interface method will be triggered every time when it got any update, and depending on that, we will update our user interface. So for that, go to your main activity and use this interface, and the interface name is sensor event listener. We are having two functions: on sensor change, if anything got changed, it will trigger this function. If our accuracy will change on that scenario, this block will be triggered. Okay, so we will use this thing later. For the time being, I'm gonna pass my activity. Next, we have to mention our sensor, so mention. Lastly, we have to pass the delay. So this delay, depending on your use case, suppose you have developed any kind of game application. So in the game application, we want these step counters as soon as possible. So for that, we are having our sensor manager. In this, we are having a lot of options: sensor delay game, sensor delay UI, and we are having sensor delay fastest. So sensor delay fastest will provide you fastest counter updates. So I'm gonna use sensor delay fastest. Okay, so now we are having our sensor, which is registered in our sensor manager. Go to on sensor change function, and in this function, first thing first, I'm gonna change this name from P0 to sensor event. So when our sensor event, I'm gonna call this event. If our event dot sensor dot type, if it is equals to sensor dot type step detector, that means we will receive counter updates, and in this case I'm gonna update my user interface. So for that, on the top I'm gonna create a variable private wall counter. This thing is initialized with the help of mutable stateflow. Type is int, and initial value would be 0. Once we receive any update, I'm gonna use my counter and update my value. So take its previous value it and use plus 1. That's it. So this will update my counter mutable state flow. Now it's time to write our user interface. So go to set content surface, and in this surface I'm gonna use a column. So this column having modifier fill max size, and it's a vertical alignment on the center. Similarly, it's horizontal alignment also in the center. Now I'm gonna check my permission. So in order to take step counter updates, we have to take a permission: activity recognition permission. So for that, go to your manifest, and this is already registered over here. Come back to your main activity, and here I'm gonna use a library, and this library present over here. This is actually used to take permission in Jetpack Compose. Go back to your main activity. I'm gonna create a permission naming state with the help of remember permission state. In this, we have to mention our permission. So Android manifest permission activity recognition. This is an experimental API, so make sure to use experimental permission API on your onCreate function. Now I'm gonna check when my permission dot status is granted. If it is granted, that means we will receive the permission from the user. Now it's time to use a simple text and show the counter. So counter dot value dot to string. If it is not granted, permission dot status so should reasonable. If it is true, that means permission is not granted, and on that case I'm gonna show a button, and this button will say give permission. And when user click to my button, I'm gonna use this permission.launchPermissionRequest. We are having a little problem here, and the problem is we can't use value in this composable. We have to collect this thing in a form of state. So for that, on the top, I'm gonna use here counter, and with the help of our counter.collectAsState composable function, I'm gonna collect this thing in a form of state. Now we will have no problem over here. Alright, so we are pretty much done with this thing. Now it's time to execute this application. So I'm gonna execute this app into my physical device and then walk some steps, and this will eventually update this text that we are having. Before executing our application, make sure to use launch effect, and in this launch effect, I'm gonna pass the key unit. And initially, when user launches our application for the first time, I'm gonna use permission and launch the permission request. And on the bottom, we are having on destroy. So in the on destroy, I'm gonna unregister my listener. So for that, I'm gonna use sensor manager dot unregister listener and pass my this, or you can say activity. In our on accuracy change, if you want to write any kind of logic, or you can say any kind of thing that you want to happen when your accuracy change, you can put that logic over here. But in our application, we are having a very simple step counter application, and in that application, I don't want any kind of logic for on accuracy change. Alright, so that's it for this video. I hope you like this video. It's a very simple application, but at the same time, in this video, you will learn how to use sensor manager, how to access a particular sensor depending on your requirement. So yeah, we will meet in our next video where we will discuss something new about Android. Till that, goodbye.